Good morning, and welcome to Grace Lutheran Church on this rather hot Sunday morning. I hope that you all had a good morning so far. We're having some announcements before we get started with our service, and the announcements concern what is coming up. Fall is starting, even if the temperatures don't feel like it. And next Sunday, our programming starts officially with our fall kickoff. And usually we would like invite you all to come here, worship together, and then celebrate outside in the courtyard. This year, we thought of something special. You're all invited to a drive-through, so come in your car, drive through our wonderful balloon arch, receive communion. Your fifth K through fifth grader will receive their Sunday school supplies. The middle schoolers will receive their confirmation package. If you're interested, you will receive a hymnal and or a lollipop from Tim, and you'll have the opportunity to chat with the staff and receive a balloon and just have a good time. So we are really looking forward to seeing you next Sunday between 11:30 and 1:30. Another thing I want to announce is God's Work Our Hands. So usually that would be the Saturday before Rally Day. This year we spread it out. Yesterday we had the first part. It was a big food drive, big food diapers, school supplies drive. A lot of people came and brought a lot of stuff. The chapel is full, so thanks a lot. Also, thank you to Tim and Dale for hosting this event. And the next one coming up is a habitat build on Saturday, September 19. If you're interested in that, please be in touch with Bruce Fitzgerald. I'm sure he is on the chat this morning. Just be in touch with him, and he'll let you know all the details. And an update regarding the fires up in the Santa Cruz Mountains. Mount Cross Camp wasn't burned at all. The staff is allowed back on site, and so we're really thankful for that. Thank you for all your prayers. And now Pastor Matt has some announcements.
Good morning. So I have the technical website announcements. So a couple of things to remind you of during the service today. You can participate in the chat window off to the side. If you have not already, please make a point to subscribe to our YouTube channel here. We put three or four videos or more some weeks up, so that way you can stay up to date on all of those things. I also wanted to comment in regards to our website during the service when we get to the offering. On our homepage at gracepa.org, you can find the Give a Gift, Give an Offering button. There's also a Grace Connect button, which will allow you to sign up for communications as far as what our programs are for the coming week and so on and so forth. In this day and age, as all of our programs are on Zoom, you could be literally anywhere on the planet and participate. So even if you're not local, go ahead and click on that link and help us to stay in touch with you. One last thing I wanted to mention, and this is in regards to Zoom links. So if you forgot the last email or aren't certain where to find the Zoom link for a certain program, know that you can always go to the website, and on the menu across the top of the website, look for weekly programs. Click on that. You can find every Zoom link you could ever possibly want. So go there first, and you'll find what you're looking for.
Thank you. Please stand as you are able.
Thank you.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord God, enliven and preserve your church with your perpetual mercy. Without your help, we mortals will fail. Remove far from us everything that is harmful, and lead us toward all that gives life and salvation, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
A reading from Ezekiel. So you, mortal, I have made a sentinel for the house of Israel. Whenever you hear a word from my mouth, you shall give them warning from me. If I say to the wicked, O wicked ones, you shall surely die, and you do not speak to warn the wicked to turn from their ways, the wicked shall die in their iniquity, but their blood I will require at your hand. But if you warn the wicked to turn from their ways, and they do not turn from their ways, the wicked shall die in their iniquity, but you will have saved your life. Now you, mortal, say to the house of Israel, thus you have said, our transgressions and our sins weigh upon us, and we waste away because of them. How then can we live? Say to them, as I live, says the Lord God, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from their ways and live. Turn back from your evil ways, for why will you die, O house of Israel? Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
A reading from Romans. Owe no one anything except to love one another, for the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and any other commandment are summed up in this word, Love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no wrong to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. Besides this, you know what time it is, how it is now the moment for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we became believers. The night is far gone. The day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us live honorably as in the day, not in reveling and drunkenness, not in debauchery and licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy. Instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Please stand as you are able for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, "If another member of the church sins against you, go and point out the fault when the two of you are alone. If the member listens to you, you have regained that one. But if you are not listened to, take one or two others along with you, so that every word may be confirmed by the evidence of two or three witnesses. If the member refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if the offender refuses to listen even to the church, let such a one be to you as a Gentile and a tax collector. Truly I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, truly I tell you, if two of you agree on earth about anything you ask, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there among them." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated.
Good morning. I'm so glad you're here with us today. I wanted to tell you a little story. So I've got my laptop here and I use this for work every day. But sometimes it doesn't do what I want it to do, and I get really frustrated. It feels like it might be broken. Do you think I should just like slam on the keys and like punch it until it works? That's probably not a good idea. Should I just like slam it shut and throw it on the ground? Probably not. Maybe I'll just take a deep breath and push some keys. Oh, I got it to work. I'm so glad. I need this to get on all my Zooms to see you guys. I'm really glad I took a breath and got it to work. Sometimes we can get really frustrated with things. Sometimes it's our laptops, or maybe it's our friends. We can get pretty frustrated at people sometimes when they're not listening to us or doing what we want them to do. But God reminds us that friendships are very important, that friendships give us love and give us peace, and that it's important to take care of those friendships. This laptop is kind of a silly example, like it's not my friend. But when I get frustrated and angry, it's hard for me to get it to work correctly. And friendships are the same way. When we're angry and mad, it can be really hard to have compassion for someone or to remember that we love someone. So today we wanted to do a reminder just to take a pause, take a breath, and remember that friendships are important. During this time of shelter in place, we haven't been able to gather together here at Grace to see each other and see our friends every Sunday after church and coffee hour or during Sunday school. And so our laptops have been our way that we connect to people. Jesus wants to remind us that those connections are really important, and that anytime we're gathered in God's name, that God is with us. That's really cool. Anytime we're on Zoom or in Sunday school or praying around the dinner table, God is with us. So take a deep breath and remember that God is always with you and that you are always loved. Let's say a prayer. Dear God, help us to resolve our arguments, to remember your grace, and to have good friendships. Thank you for forgiveness, and help us to pass that on to others. Thank you for your love. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
As we get close to Rally Day, our fall kickoff, I feel like every single year we have these super awkward gospel readings where Jesus is assuming that we're not going to do things perfectly and how to deal with one another, and it's kind of messy business, and to have that be front and center when we're hoping to welcome all kinds of people in and have their first experience with grace always feels a little funny. I suppose a bonus this year is that there's just like six of us here, so, and a bunch of you out there, of course. But today's text touches on a number of things, and I want to go back to a story from early in my ministry. When I graduated from seminary and had been assigned to the Northwest Minnesota Synod, Marielle and I had been married for about 4 years, and we were expecting our first child. In fact, when we moved up to Minnesota, Marielle was about 7.5, 8 months along, and we were starting in a new parish in Northwest Minnesota where we had never lived. Things were exciting. And one of the articles that Marielle had been reading was one entitled Finding Dr. Right. So this was an article about how to find the right pediatrician for your newborn, right? This was some of the reading as new parents are prone to do. And so we were reading along, and then in all of the excitement of our son's birth, and as most all of you know, significant cardiac issues, we show up in Minneapolis. Eli has been flown to Children's Hospital there, and we meet his cardiologist that Eli apparently found all on his own, and he introduced himself and he said, "Hi, I'm Dr. Greg Wright." And we thought, "Of course you are. Of course you are, Dr. Wright." One of the times when Eli had surgery, I remember standing in the ICU following, and it had been about a day after surgery. We were starting to breathe a little easier. We walked in and we saw Dr. Wright standing at the bedside, which was not terribly unusual during rounds. But there were two other cardiologists also hovering over the bed. And they were talking for quite a while. And we were standing off a bit, not wanting to interrupt, but feeling increasingly anxious as this powwow was carrying on. And eventually, the other two cardiologists left, and we approached Dr. Wright to say, "What's going on? Is everything okay?" And he looked at us kind of surprised and said, "Yeah, everything's fine." He said, "You know, when we're all standing here, it's good to remember that just like an airplane that's on autopilot, the pilots don't all just leave the cockpit. It's always good to be watching." I was reminded of this story as we think of the text that we have today, because when we talk about our relationships with one another, certainly the text is focusing on relationships within the life of the church, within the life of the parish, but this is true for any relationship. In fact, in premarital counseling, we will often use this kind of language to say that relationships require active maintenance on a regular basis, even when things are going perfectly smoothly. Even then, they require maintenance. Good relationships individually, within a faith community, and even broader, require active management and tending. The idea that we deal with one another directly, person to person, and not in third parties. Now, that's hard for human beings, because we get hurt sometimes, and we tend to deal with that hurt in different ways, and not all the time are those ways necessarily healthy. They're not always the ways in which we would want to deal with one another. There's a movie that came out several years ago. It was an animated film, or is an animated film, by Pixar called Wreck-It Ralph. Now, some of you are maybe familiar with this movie, but the movie is about a video game and the characters in that video game and how they deal with one another. Wreck-It Ralph's job in his video game is to wreck stuff, and Fix-It Felix is the one who fixes it, right? Well, in the second installment of this movie, it is Ralph Breaks the Internet. It was a great update. And Ralph finds himself in the internet, which is this vast, endless city and metropolis of things, and he is in need of finding a way to fix something for a friend. And this requires money. And how he gets this money is by embarrassing himself through YouTube videos. Now, I know you can't imagine this scenario, but nonetheless, there he is with one embarrassing film after the next, after the next, after the next. But the part of the story that is particularly touching is the moment that he begins to notice the comments that are happening on the YouTube videos. The comments, right? The comments. We all know when we read a news story, when we go to social media, what are you not supposed to do? Read the comments, right? They're horrible. And they're particularly horrible when they are what? Anonymous. Anonymous, right? The worst of who we are as human beings comes out in anonymous comments. This is the hazard and the brokenness of humanity as expressed in relationships, and it's worse when we feel like there is more distance. One of the other things that comes to mind when I think of this gospel text in particular is the time that I worked at Mount Cross Camp here in the Santa Cruz Mountains. Again, most of you know, I spent 4 summers at Mount Cross working as leadership staff and as a counselor. And one of the things about working at a camp is you have this profound sense of community. You are eating together, sleeping together, working together in the same jobs. There is a tightness in community that you likely won't experience anywhere else in your whole life. In fact, so much can happen in such a short period of time that the expression we had on staff is that time at camp is dense. You will find people start dating at the beginning of the summer and they're engaged at the end of the summer. Things happen at like warp speed because of this tight community. But on the flip side, drama can come up swiftly. And it's a challenge. It's a challenge to deal with that. And in outdoor ministry, it is well known that drama has to be dealt with quickly and face to face. Because anonymous snittering around the edges is something that is just awful and corrosive to the community. Face-to-face, direct communication is what Christ is calling us to, and not because it's easy. I think that's where we get lost sometimes, is that the idea that the easiest path is somehow the best or the healthiest, and that is almost never the case. If we've been hurt, we often want to step aside, talk to other parties that are not even related to the issue at hand. And instead, Christ says, no, be bold. Do not be anonymous. Speak directly to one another. Build community in a way that shows your authentic self and deals with other people in a direct and heartfelt fashion, assuming the best in one another. That's not always the easiest thing to do. But one of the things that I find interesting in this text is that when Jesus challenges us in how to deal with one another when we are not at our best, doesn't seem like the best story, does it? It's like Jesus is turning to us and saying, I know you all are going to mess this up. And when you do, here's what you should do. So we have that piece. But this reading ends with probably one of the most powerful aspects of grace and gospel of any reading that we will have during this year. Where two or three are gathered, when you are doing the hard, awkward work of maintaining healthy relationships and community, when you're in the midst of that, that is exactly where you will find me. You will find me when you are doing that work in my name. And so while Jesus may have assumptions about when we fall short, there is a profound promise to be in our midst when we are doing that work. So as we move into this new year, let us continue to do that work. Let us keep bringing Christ in our midst, that communities might be whole and healthy, and that we might be our best Christ-centered selves for the sake of the world. Amen.
Please stand as you are able. Together with the siblings all over the world, let us confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Drawn together in the compassion of God, we pray for the Church, the world, and all those in need. Unite your Church, O God. Grant us the gifts of repentance and reconciliation in our congregation, in our communities, and in the world. Strengthen ecumenical partnerships. Guide the work of the Lutheran World Federation, the World Council of Churches, and the work of churches in our community. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Protect your creation, O God. Teach us ways that do not harm what you have entrusted to our care. Renew and enliven places suffering from drought, flood, storms, fires, or pollution. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Turn nations and leaders from ways that lead to death, O God. Shape new paths toward peace and cooperation, teaching us to recognize one another as neighbors. Guide legislators, civil servants, judges, and police toward laws that protect the well-being of all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Tend to all in need of your compassion, O God. Hear the cries of those awaiting justice and those yearning for forgiveness. Give community to the lonely and neighbors to the outcast. Shelter all who are vulnerable in body, mind, or spirit. Be especially with Ilse's mother and all those we name in our hearts or out loud now. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Sustain us in our work, O God, and give work to those who need it. Shape societies to ensure fair treatment of all who labor. Help us to love our neighbors in and through our work. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, we remember with thanksgiving those who have died in faith. As you equip them, equip us with your protection and power, until with them we see your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. All these things and whatever else you see that we need, we entrust to your mercy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's take a moment and share that peace here in the sanctuary, at your homes, and in the chat. Peace be with you.
Peace.
Peace, Elizabeth. You may be seated. At this point, we receive the offering. You can give online. There are a few options, text to give, and there is also a form that you can fill in for giving. And then, of course, always you can mail a check. I just want to take the opportunity to thank you for your generous offerings, but also thank our musicians here in the church and those that made a recording, Katie and Israel, who arranged the piece that was the prelude. Thank you very much. Please stand as you're able. God of justice and love, we give thanks to you that you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need, awaken us to the needs of others, and at the end, bring all the world to your feast. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom, with you and the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory forever. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor hate, nor death, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. God the Creator, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit the Comforter bless you and keep you in eternal love. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
forward to seeing you at coffee hour now on Zoom. You can find the link if you go to our website, www.gracepa.org, and click on weekly programming. It's up on the top. That will lead you to all the Zoom links we have through our week. Today, you want the Sunday coffee hour Zoom link. Looking forward to seeing you there. Go in peace. Christ is with you.
Thanks be to God.